Welcome to another episode of VMblog's Work From Home series. Today, we're very happy to have with us Stacy Leidwinger, the Chief Marketing Officer at Goliath Technologies. Stacy, thanks for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.
Before we dive in, would you give viewers a quick overview about Goliath?
Yeah, so at Goliath, we provide end-user experience monitoring and troubleshooting software across Citrix and VMware Horizon environments, regardless where users are located.
And today, as part of the Work From Home series, one of the things we're obviously talking about is the pandemic. It's a major topic these days. Mm-hmm. How has it changed the way companies are dealing with their employees? And what are you hearing from your own customers? Were they caught by surprise, or did they already have solutions in place to quickly make the shift to work, you know, work from home possible?
So what I think the surge of remote working's done is it's put that employee experience at the forefront of every conversation. So organizations need to keep their employees safe, motivated, and productive if they're going to fight through the pandemic themselves. And then what I see is a lot of the burden of enabling this remote workforce so they can be successful at home has fallen on the shoulders of IT. So when I talked to some of our customers, when this first happened and everyone went home when COVID started to create that work from home scenario, they were working 18, 20 hours a day just to make sure people had the right equipment to work from home, that they were enabling their home devices, they had access to the right applications, security was being set up. No one knew how long this was going to last, when people would be coming back. And so all that burden to create this strong experience at home really fell onto IT. Now, some people were ready. They invested in tools like virtualized desktop and applications. But even then, there's a lot of nuances when someone moves from a home office environment or from an office environment where they're at to home. And there's a lot of subtleties around how they access, how they get applications, where they go for support. So I think everyone was hit at some level, some organizations a lot more than others.
And Stacy, for the companies that are starting to move to or have already migrated over to a work from home strategy, how do you think this is affecting the people, the connectivity, the infrastructure?
Mm-hmm. Again, I really look at how it's impacted IT. Right? IT and those that are supporting the work from home are really one of the unsung heroes of this entire pandemic, right? And so I think what's happened is people aren't used to working from home and they're not used to managing their home environment as an office environment. So what has happened is IT has gone from supporting maybe one main office with a dozen or a handful of offices to actually supporting thousands of home office environments. And then users expect everything to work as it has worked in the past. They expect to be able to collaborate as easily as they maybe have in the office. So there's been this ongoing kind of friction and challenge. And I think people have been accepting, but it's still, they need to do their job. And so it's how do we ensure we set expectations of how people can be successful and in what time frames IT is going to be able to provide them this home infrastructure to make them successful.
And so what are some of the things that Goliath has been doing to help enable work from home?
Mm-hmm. So I go back to some of the inherent challenges that existed even before people went to work from home. So a lot of organizations had invested in virtualized desktops and applications from a Citrix or a VMware Horizon. As probably many of the viewers know, it's complex to create these end user experiences. It's not just deploying Citrix. It's deploying 15 vendors that have to work in concert together in order to deliver a strong user experience. And then there's an element of end user behavior. What is the endpoint? What other applications are they running on the end user experience? What's the Wi-Fi or their internet connection like? So when you look at the surge of remote working, that initial part of creating a virtual workspace now has multiple different elements of end user behavior. People are using older devices if they didn't have one, they're using their own. They have different levels of Wi-Fi connectivity. Their ISP vendors are different. They don't, you know, many users don't realize that, wait, it works great when I'm working at my kitchen counter, but then I go to my third floor and everything slows down. Well, your router's on the first floor and that little bit of distance with a bad ISP makes a difference for you. And so what Goliath does is we provide end-to-end visibility across all of those end user elements I talked about, the endpoint, the behaviors, the connection that they're leveraging, plus all of that infrastructure to deliver a Citrix or VMware all the way back to the data center. And with that visibility, we enable organizations to anticipate, troubleshoot, and document end user performance issues, again, whether they're in the office or at home. And so for us, we've been doing this for years now across industries. I give an example of healthcare, because healthcare workers have always been distributed and almost always thought of as remote. Even if they're in the same healthcare facility in the hospital, they're moving from the first floor, the third floor, the fifth floor. So they've always been treated as almost a remote worker. And so our ability to give that visibility into the end user experience based on behavior, also all the IT elements, and then even in healthcare, we bring in the EHR applications like an Epic, a Cerner, a Meditech, Allscripts to deliver that visibility so that they can easily troubleshoot when issues come up. Also, we have embedded intelligence and automation that allows us to proactively identify what things should be watched and monitored, and then alert anytime there's a threshold that's exceeded so IT can handle the issue before end users are even impacted. And then finally, we provide documentation that really gives visibility into what's going on, identifying trends, allowing you to foster conversations of, is the issue when a slow logon occurs, is it because of the end user and something going on at their endpoint or their Wi-Fi connection? Or do I need to talk to our storage team because there might be something going in on the underlying infrastructure in the data center that's impacting performance? And so that's really how we help organizations ensure they're delivering high performing end user experiences, because they can go ahead and prevent issues and they can troubleshoot and resolve them quickly if they do arise.
I talked about troubleshooting problems. What is some of the biggest questions that you're being asked by your customers as they're adopting this work from home model?
I would sum up, we get asked two major questions. The first is, are my systems performing at a high enough quality that my employees can be productive? And secondly, are my employees being productive while they work from home? And that first question really comes back to, can you deliver reports and data across the behavior as well as the infrastructure all the way into the data center so that you're showing things like average logon times, average ICA latency if you're a Citrix user, and really getting a feel for, are the systems there supporting the experience you want to provide? And then actually at Goliath, we've added new capabilities to our product to help support the surge in remote working, and our customers helped give a lot of input in what this would be. And one of the reports that we now offer, we call the End User Productivity Report. So you can actually identify how active a user is within their Citrix session. What's their max time of inactivity? What applications are they actually accessing? So we work with a customer, Empire Office, and they came to us and said, how can we have a better feel for if our users are really being successful at home? So we actually had, they had offices in Manhattan. It's the first time people were working from home, and they're a family-owned business. So it wasn't being big brother. It was really understanding with everything going on, many of their employees had kids from home that they're trying to homeschool. They didn't know if they had access to the right applications. And so they wanted insights on what was their average workday and what did it look like? And what they found is people were logging on earlier, they were staying on later, they were working on the weekends. And their number one concern actually ended up being not are people working, but instead are they working too much? And what other things can we do to make sure that they're still having a traditional work-life balance through this pandemic?
Yeah, that's a great point. And you talked about a number of challenges already, but focusing on security, are there things that companies should be paying special attention to now that people are working from home rather than in the office?
Of course. And something I've talked about even in prior lives before joining Goliath is this concept of the careless user. And I think the careless user is one of the top security threats for any organization, right? You accidentally click on a link that's a phishing email scam. You download a printer driver that has malware attached. And the risk of careless user behavior only increases when you're at home because you've become your own IT department trying to solve issues so you can just do your job. And so I think what organizations really need to do, and I think it's one of the top preventative measures when it comes to the careless user, is investing in that kind of centralized management and security infrastructure, giving people access to the right tools that they need to do their job. Because if people can be successful, they're less likely engaging in that careless behavior.
And Stacy, out of all these, you know, technologies that come together to make up this work from home experience, what would you say are the key technologies that kind of make up this new environment?
So I just hinted at it when I talked about security, but I really think organizations should be looking at like a Citrix or a VMware Horizon to deliver the virtualized application and desktop, because it's the only way you're going to have central management, but yet end users have that seamless experience and the access to the applications that they need. And then secondarily to that is, if you're going to engage in that type of technology, you do need a purpose-built tool that's focused on monitoring and troubleshooting that end user experience and gives you visibility into end user behavior. Because it's only when you have visibility into what's going on at the endpoint or the home office that you're going to be able to deliver that high performing experience overall.
And based on, you know, everything that you know now and, you know, where we are with this pandemic, do you have any tips that you might be able to share with people that could, you know, to be doing things better to prepare for, you know, if something happens like this again in the near future?
So my biggest advice is be proactive and don't fall into the trap that things are going to get better once that initial spike happens. Meaning, yes, we've had some hiccups around the end user experience, but it'll get better now that we understand what's going on. And it comes back to, and I've said it a lot, end user behavior. End user behavior is always going to be unpredictable. Delivering these virtualized desktop and applications is always going to be complex, and you're probably not going to get more resources to support them. So if you wait too long to invest in the right tools that are going to allow you to anticipate issues and move into that proactive state, you're always going to be catching up. And I use an example. We have a customer, Penn National Insurance, and they actually initiated a work from home program last year. So what did they do? They turned to Citrix to deliver the virtual workspace. They looked at iGel to have as their thin client so they could leverage the hardware they already had in place. And they leveraged Goliath so that they had that visibility and could troubleshoot issues when it came up quickly. And it was great that they had Goliath because the project was almost put on hold indefinitely because a few users were saying, you know what, my home Wi-Fi is really slow, this isn't working, Cisco soft phone calls are dropping. And what we were able to do was give them visibility, and they talked to their end user and said, it looks like performance is great till about 3 o'clock. What happens at 3 o'clock? And this was a year ago, right? So they said, well, that's when my kids come home from school, they get online, they like to game. And they said, well, you know that impacts your bandwidth and your network connectivity, because you can see your connection speed goes down right at 3 o'clock. And so what did they do? They invested in an ISP. They told their kids they couldn't be online till 5 o'clock after work hours. But that's the kind of visibility that people need to have. And this work style is probably going to last for a while. And so my biggest advice, again, is don't wait. Get proactive. Invest in tools that you can get visibility into what's going on, because it's the only way you're going to get ahead of some of these issues that keep continually happening.
Now, you talked about this continuing on, and I think you're right that this work from home is with us to stay now that people have adopted and got used to working in their shorts and their t-shirts and not having to take that commute to go into the office. I guess I got two questions. One of them being, if they're so happy at home and working from home, how do you get these people to come back to the office? And is there a cost savings for keeping them, you know, not in the office, because now you can have a smaller office space, you know, less workers?
So I think one of the great things is it doesn't have to be my opinion. It doesn't have to be an organization's HR leader, CEO leader's decision. I really encourage people to go back to the data, right? The data is going to tell us what you need to drive productivity in your business. And I've talked to customers that have said, I can look, our back office, our payroll, our finance team, they're being extremely successful from home. I can see when they're logging in. I can see them being highly productive. I'm not getting complaints. But I will tell you, the team that has issues is our design team, because some of the CAD software they're using is extremely bandwidth intensive. And it doesn't matter that they've upgraded their ISP, they're still having slowness. And also they're struggling to really not be able to whiteboard and innovate in some of the collaboration systems. And you see those requests coming in, support tickets, asking for access for these applications. And so I really encourage organizations as they start to think about it as rely on as much data as you can gather. Do employee surveys, but also look at the systems you have and start identifying, are people being productive? What applications are they using? How has work changed since they went home? And are all those elements gonna still allow your employees to be, back to what I just said, safe, motivated, productive? And is it allowing you to drive your business forward with your goals, making sure that you're delivering shareholder value, customer value, all those things that are ingrained in our businesses every day?
Well, before we let you go, I wanted to ask, one final question is, where can folks go who are watching this to learn more about your company, your technologies, and do you guys have anything specific on your site maybe that targets work from home?
Yep. So you can go to goliathtechnologies.com and everything you would need to learn about us is right there. We do have, and in fact, on our homepage, we talk about some of the data and reports that we offer specifically for work from home initiatives. We've got special programs, special pricing, special incentives, because we truly do want to help people get through this pandemic. And we also offer a free trial of our software. So if people are interested, they can email in at techinfo@goliathtechnologies.com, and we will get you set up so that you can start looking at some of those reports and some of that visibility that we can provide within your own infrastructure.
Well, great. Well, Stacy, thanks a lot for taking time to speak with VMblog, and we appreciate your expertise on this topic.
Thanks for having me, and thanks for really doing this overall program. I think it's great sharing tips and tricks with everyone out there.
Great. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to see more of these VMblog videos, please hit the like button and subscribe. And it's important, if you want to get notified the next time we post a video, please hit the subscribe and the bell notification.